Hi, Aki Karim here for BBTV. I am delighted to be joined by the man right here who is 7 times Irish champ. He's also 8-0 as a professional, 7 by way of. This guy's not messing. It's Tiernan Bradley. It's good to see you, mate, and it's great to see that your journey's going so well. Tell me about the rock and roll roller coaster you've had over the last few years.
Yeah, I mean, since the last time I was talking to you, I was talking to you in Manchester. I was up sparring Stephen Daniel and Tyrone Nurse in Fight Factory. So that was a long time ago, and a lot has happened ever since. After that, I went into camp with McGregor for the Mayweather fight, and then after I came out of camp with him, I was thinking of turning pro straight away, and it was always on my mind, but that kind of solidified it. And then things just never materialized. I moved away to New York, took a little break from boxing, and then decided, right, one last push, turning, let's get it going. To be fair, in that little break, I put on 4 stone. I was living life. I was getting my head right after I'd say 13, 14 years of boxing. I needed a little break for myself. And then when I took the break and was ready to get back in, it was tough getting back. You're dropping that 4 stone, getting the fitness back. Now, saying that, my ring fitness was always still there, even when it was heavy. I think just not at a high level. Moved down to Dublin, trained with my old coach, Stephen O'Rourke. Lived down there for, say, 4 years, and then I just decided to kind of make the jump then to come over to Brighton and train with Scott's my manager also, and it's probably been the best move for me. He's a fantastic coach, and they're a fantastic team to be around. I'm really happy where I am right now.
It's fantastic to see you actually progressing so well. I mean, we actually did speak when you were in camp with Mayweather. I don't know if you remember, but it was a while ago now, obviously. But you were just sort of almost a bit starstruck at the time because you just got this call. You were a young amateur, fresh amateur, and you were in there with basically a mixed martial arts legend. How much do you think that experience brought you on in your full combat career?
Yeah, I mean, in terms of my boxing and stuff, it probably didn't do me any different. You know, it was just another sparring camp. There were hard rounds, you know. But I think it was the entire process of being involved in such a massive fight, you know, in a massive camp, and seeing how things are running through media-wise and things, and how to present yourself and act in those situations. I know Conor sometimes may not be the best person to be, you know, copying in the media, but he does it in such a bravado in a way that grabs people's eyes. And he's very good at manipulating the market. And I learned a lot of that. Even I was with Conor at the weekend. We flew to Denver on his private jet to watch the bare knuckle. And even just listening to him again and with him reiterating stuff and even hearing some of his mindset changes to when he was then, when he was younger, it's been absolutely crazy. But no, I think it'll stand. I think that camp will stand to me whenever I'm up there, you know, whenever I reach the higher points in my career, you know, in bigger fights, you know, in the lead up to bigger fights, because it won't faze me now, because I've been involved in one of the biggest fights possibly there ever been. So yeah, I think that's how it's going to stand for me in my career.
you mentioned a very interesting point there, because you mentioned it's not always just about boxing skill. I've always known you've had this skill, even from when you were an amateur, but marketability in today's society in the boxing game is a huge part of it. The Instagram, all them. I mean, I don't know much, you know, I'm not a big thing on it, but I know how important it is. Yeah. Now, do you think then that, you know, without giving away the secrets, you know, a formula which could help you alongside your actual boxing skill then to get quite big in the next coming years?
Well, there is no real formula. I mean, it's just putting yourself out there. And in every sense, you know, people are interested in everything you do these days, no matter be what you're cooking, what you're eating, how you're training, where you're training, who you're training with, you know. So it's all about getting new viewers into the sport. I mean, that's why me, myself, I'm not personally pissed off about, you know, any of these YouTuber fights, because anybody that's watching them YouTuber fights is their own viewers that they've built up over the years. And people talk about, oh, they're taking our money, they're taking our money. They aren't taking no money, because their viewers were going to pay for that anyway, no matter if they went and played a golf tournament, a tennis tournament. So it's all about building those viewers in your own sense and marketing yourself well and having that likability sense, you know. So as I said, I don't think there's any real formula, but just be yourself.
I saw a clip, because actually I went on your Instagram today to get some notes for this interview. And that's when I saw you must have gone on this trip with Conor McGregor recently. Yeah. What was it like being in the private jet? And I saw a little clip of him showing you a few little footwork things and like that. But let's talk about private jet first, because not many people get to go on one of them. What was that whole experience like? Did it give you a good sense of the high life and something to aspire to?
Yeah. I mean, I don't really like to, you know, feel that way, because then you feel like you've kind of made it, but yeah, you haven't. I just take in the experience and wonder, is this going to be my life when I'm older, you know? I know only the top 1% make it in that sense, and Conor is that top 1%. So yeah, I mean, it doesn't really faze me too much, because I don't let it faze me, you know, because I can mess up a lot of people. But it was an incredible experience, and I'm really grateful to Conor for having me on there and bringing me to Denver and seeing the bare knuckle. So it was good. It was good seeing him again, getting the catch up, you know.
Yeah, great experience. You've also had, you know, in terms of boxing experience, you've recently been sparring with Conor Benn, which obviously caught my eye, because, you know, you're again proving that these top fighters want you in their camp. But also, again, you're in camp there with someone who's hot in the media. Let's just talk about how that was for a start, the experience of the actual sparring itself. How was it?
Yeah, it was great sparring. Conor's a really, really good lad. We spoke before, we spoke after. And he was over there training, you know, supporting his teammate, John Ryder. We got to see John spar for his final spar before the fight. The gym was absolutely roasting. But yeah, it was a great experience to spar with Conor, you know, and somewhere I can gauge my level as well.
And how did you gauge it? I mean, were you competitive in the spar? Did you feel that at your 8 fights in, you know, you did okay in the spar?
Yeah, I mean, I think I really impressed Conor. I don't want to say it too much, because I really like Conor. You know, I've met him a few times. And he's a really nice guy. A lot of stuff that he gets in the media is rather horrible, if it is true that he's found not guilty. You know, it is something that would finish somebody's career off. For this man to be standing tall with his head held high, after these allegations. Yeah, I think. I mean, we'll wait and see. With what's going to happen.
Obviously, whatever you think about that particular situation, on a humanistic level, he's still a guy with feelings who's gone through a lot in the media. Did you get a chance to actually speak about that, how he is at the minute, how his mental state is, how he just is as a person in himself at the minute?
No, didn't really speak about any of that. Spoke about boxing. I mean, as anybody said, like if with anybody in boxing, you just go in there and speak about boxing. You don't talk about private stuff. You know, it's the same way, you know, that when people talk about when you go into a boxing gym, you're mixing with criminals, you're mixing with policemen, but we don't talk about our private. Just talk about boxing because we're real boxing people. So, I wasn't talking about any of that.
Fair enough, mate. I mean, you are real, as you say, a real boxing person. You're 8-0 at the minute, 7 KOs to your name. So generally, when people start out, they're in against these sort of tough, tricky journeymen who know how to handle, they know how to survive. You're stopping kids. You're coming off the back of a second round stoppage win, I believe, as well, an eye-catching shot. So where's this punching power coming from? Because has this always been a feature of your game? Have you always been a big puncher? Were you a big puncher like that in the amateurs?
I've been a big puncher since a very young age, but I never utilised it. You know, I've broken ribs in fights, you know, when I was younger. And then as I continued on, I started just, and with the national setup of the Irish team, it's a very negative kind of way of boxing, like an old Soviet kind of way of boxing, because our coach was Zarantia, a Georgian coach. So it's very much in and out boxing. Whereas now, you know, worked with Stephen O'Rourke, a Manchester lad. It's very much a high-paced, aggressive fighter. Switch hitting. And now that I've brought it over now to Brighton, to Scott and Benny Pringle, I've really utilised, you know, even the heavyweight punching that Scott had. And the slickness that Benny's been brought into my game as well. So I can get in there, lay off my shots and get out of there very quickly. Which is something I never really done. I never really sat down on my shots. But we're seeing the full true extent of my power now. It's frightening. It's frightening.
Well, you've mentioned Scott and Tommy a few times. So just for people who are watching, you're, of course, talking about Scott and Tommy Welch. So Scott's now your manager. Tommy, heavyweight, unbeaten heavyweight. I think he's 10-0 at the minute, I believe. This is the camp you're talking about. Got a good team to be around. Tell us a little bit more about the inner workings of this new setup for you then, because I know Tommy's going great guns as well. He's out on the 27th of May coming up. Does this mean we're going to see you perhaps box in England? Is this the plan going forward? Are the people you know in England, Wales, Ireland? I know you box in Ireland, but you know, are the people in England going to see you a bit more now?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, my fight before the last was in Bournemouth, which was fun. Fun to fight in front of English fans. I'd like to fight on some of these big shows now. Maybe even a Frank Warren show, boxer show, Wasserman. I've got the option of fighting on all them. I'm entertaining, so why not have me on them shows? And it also brings new viewers from Ireland as well. But yeah, and I sell a lot of tickets. A lot of my family, a lot of my friends fly over. You know, my last fight, I had people coming over from America to Galway in Ireland to watch me fight. Really want to like get on them big shows on a bigger platform. Start getting my name out there properly and showing everybody the skills that I have, not just showing people on Instagram, you know, my finishes, my highlight reels. I want to show it live on Sky Sports, the devastation that my hands have.
Well, I was about to ask you if you had a choice of preferred platform, what would it be? So is that the answer? You'd prefer to go on the Sky platform? Because I'm sure some of these promoters will be watching, especially with what the title of this video is going to be.
Yeah, I mean, Sky's the one at the moment. You know what I mean? You know, you've got Eddie and you've got Frank there with BT Sport. But you know, everybody dreams of growing up and fighting on Sky Sports. You know, am I wrong? You know, I
No,
grew up.
a lot of people I speak to in your situation, they do
Yeah.
say that because they grew up watching it, yeah.
Exactly. Grew up watching, you know, football. You know, soccer Saturday. You know what I mean? So I would love to fight on Sky Sports someday, and it's a fantastic platform. Yeah, but I don't mind fighting. I want all the platforms. I want to fight on all the platforms. Maybe I go along and take them all off the list.
Take them, take your mate, just take over the world. Why not? I mean, it's an
Exactly.
ambitious attitude, but I know that is where, you know, that's what you're like at the minute. You know, you're ambitious, you're young, you're only eight fights in, so the world is your oyster. Is there anything in the pipeline? Is there anything in the pipeline for your next fight, or is this the stage now where you're looking to jump onto that next deal with someone?
No, there's definitely something in the pipeline there. Yeah, I can't say too much now, but I'm stepping up into my eight rounder in my next fight, my first eight rounder. And then maybe get three eight rounders before the end of the year. Get five, maybe even four eight rounders before the end of the year. And, you know, God willing, injury free. And maybe even a title at the end of the year. You know, I want to stay busy. I want to keep building up, you know, to that top level, maybe hit top 50 ranking, you know, by the end of the year. And it's very doable, very doable.
You've got a young team around you in a sense, because Ben Pringle is well, everyone's young to me, but he's a young lad. He is a young trainer, isn't he? And Tommy himself is a young heavyweight. We're only talking 20s here. So what's it like being around a young team? Because a lot of time, actually, that's fresh blood. You know, a lot of times people have got older coaches and things like, what's that like?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the thing with Benny, you know, he goes under the radar. You know, he's probably one of the best young coaches coming through in the amateurs and the pros. He dedicates his life to the team and to boxing. And that's admirable to anybody, you know. It's absolutely crazy. I've never seen somebody so dedicated. You know, he's up in the mornings at 6:30 waiting for us outside to go for our runs. He's there at the boxing gym, and he has a young family as well, so that can be very hard. So it's the passion that he has, and the good thing is he's a fantastic lad as well. You know, he's cooking for us over here. He's cooking his breakfast, lunch, and dinner. He's doing the dishes. He's keeping everybody right, you know, so that we can get our proper rest. There's not many people that have that passion, and I'm grateful to have him in the team. And also with Tommy is going to be fresh in the heavyweight scene. It's going to be explosive whenever he gets in the mix between them guys. You know, Tommy's a relatively small heavyweight, but I've seen him fight the biggest of the biggest. And you know what they say? The bigger they are, the harder they fall. And I think that this is gonna this is that that's gonna happen whenever Tommy steps in there. So he's a great addition to that heavyweight mix, not only in Britain but also in America also. You know, coming over here, sparring. It's great to see kind of the mix of styles as well, not just the British heavyweight scene, but in the American heavyweight scene. I think Tommy can cause a few, not really upsets, but just throw a spanner in the works and all that, which is great, which is going to be fantastic for the fans of the heavyweight division.
Yeah, I had the pleasure of working for Hennessy Sports during one of his fights, and it was explosive. And I did sit up and take notes. So it looks like you're in the right place, guys. Two explosive, young, hungry fighters coming through the ranks there. Is there a message you want to give to people about why they need to jump on and look out for Tien and Bradley? Is there a message?
Let me see. Nah, I mean, I'm fresh to the game, you know, to this professional business within the UK, because I've done most of my stuff in Europe. So, as I said with Tommy in the heavyweight division, he can throw a spanner in the works. I can also throw a spanner in the works as well. There's a lot of these guys that I can beat, you know, whether it be in the light welterweight division or even the welterweight division. I don't mind anybody who's there. I've been watching these guys for years, and they're not up to scratch. And I'm hungry, as you says. I'm hungry for their blood. I'm like a shark in blood and fasted waters. I'm looking forward to it.
You heard the man. You heard the man. He's like a shark in blood-infested waters. He's coming for everyone in those divisions. It's been a pleasure speaking to you, Tiernan. It's been really good catching up, and I hope we can do this again a bit more regularly, because it'd be great to keep up with the progress, mate, really.
Absolutely. Appreciate it, Aggie.